primarily you need to know that you're not doing anything wrong. Primarily you need to know that you're not hurting anybody, and what you're doing you're confident about and happy with, and then you don't kind of give off any bad vibes, you don't give off you know, stalker vibes, you don't give off fear. And you know, we're animals, we smell fear a mile off. Sometimes you can be walking down the street and walk into something, take something and walk out and feel like you were totally invisible. And invisibility would be my superpower if I could choose one. Every now and then when you're doing street photography, you can come into something and come out of a whole situation, you know, an argument, you know, love or something happening, and you can go in and you can share it with these people, and you can go out and they didn't realise you were there. And that's a really nice feeling too. And again, it feels a very meditative sense of being. I found that I get more and more interested in the things that I didn't see than the things that I did. And so sometimes, I mean, you know, you just have luck on your side. It's really exciting to look through a contact sheet and find a picture that really works, but you didn't expect it to work. I think reality is very important to me. It's I'm not a great fiction reader, you know. I like fact, and I think that applies with photography as well. For me, picking something that's real out and showing reality is far more interesting. The lovely thing about street photography as well is that the best stuff, there's absolutely no way you could stage or even think of. It's just like, it happened, and isn't that weird? And it's gone. I think the most, you know, the craziest stuff is the stuff that's generally real, and the stuff that you can make up is less impressive. Yeah.